Kamala Khan has been Jersey City's number one defender, but what will the city do for her in a time of need? Well, let's hop into the pages of Ms. Marvel issue number 37 and find out for ourselves, shall we? Alrighty then, so as we join the comic, our hero is readying to face her most dangerous challenge to date. No, it's not another supervillain or an alien takeover, or even the many growing pains of being a teenager. No, it's taking care of a young child, in this case, Kamala's new young cousin. At first, her and Gabe are all gung-ho about it. Ah, this is no problem. We got this handled. My brother, your sister, they got nothing to worry about. They're gonna thank us when this is all done. And then the baby starts crying and all of this positivity crumbles away. Knowing full well that they can't handle any of this on their own, they decide to take the baby to Circle Q in hopes that someone there will be able to help. And lucky for them, Iman Abdullah is there picking up some groceries. Being an older gentleman with 3 children of his own and 7 grandchildren, obviously he knows how to deal with a gassy baby. You know, I don't know if I've ever said it before, but I really like how this series deals with Iman Abdullah. He's a religious dude, but religion doesn't define him as a character. He's just a nice, normal dude who helps out the cast. Now, with the baby problem out of the way, it's time for Ms. Marvel to deal with yet another threat. It seems that Jersey City is flooding. Now, what could possibly be causing this? Is the Hydro Man on a rampage? Is Namor choosing now to attack New York? It's none of those things, actually. It's just crappy New Jersey infrastructure. The city was supposed to replace those water mains 2 years ago, but they didn't, and now this is happening. Friggin' Chris Christie, I bet this is his fault. Now, with Ms. Marvel out and about trying to save as many people as she can from drowning and save as much property as she can, it falls to Bruno and Gabe to watch over the baby, and they almost instantly whiff it. The baby ends up getting carried downstream a la Noah, and quite ironically, given that reference, he's found by Naphtali and his sister, Kamala's Jewish friend. You'll recall this dude actually tracked Kamala down when she briefly decided to give up the superhero life, and if you enjoy this cameo, get ready, because this issue is nothing but cameos. Naphtali hands the baby off to Old Man Harold. You'll recall that him and a bunch of other old people were being experimented on by the Inventor, one of Ms. Marvel's maybe only recurring bad guys. Turns out Harold was in the Navy during the war, so he's more than capable of traversing rough waters, and he's heading back into town anyway, so he's gonna try and hunt down Kamala on his own. It's while doing that he ends up coming across Mike and Nakia, 2 friends of Kamala who just so happen to be dressed in DIY body armor right now. Why? Well, when the city flooded, all the zoo animals had gotten loose, and because of that they took it upon themselves to try and get them back in their cages. A pretty heroic thing to do, and then you're reminded these two actually dressed up as Ms. Marvel while she was briefly away, so it's up their alley. The two girls opt to take the baby the rest of the way, and eventually they do end up coming face to face with Ms. Marvel, who, get this, was actually able to fix the water mains because she knew where they were, because in the very first arc, the Inventor made his base by the water mains in the sewer. Now, all things considered, this is a pretty happy if chaotic day, but some bad news ends up coming down the pipeline. It seems that when the flooding started, Iman Abdullah had a heart attack. Kamala rushes to the hospital, fearing the worst for her friend, not wanting him to die and having their last conversation be over gassy babies. Kamala also wonders if she throws herself so much into the superhero life because at the end of the day, it's actually a lot less stressful than the rigors of real life. That's actually a pretty profound observation, and you could probably levy that at a lot of different superheroes. Luckily, Abdullah is fine, and the whole heart attack thing was greatly overhyped. He will be out of action for a little bit, though, and hey, wouldn't you know it, Amir is looking for a job. So until the old Iman is back on his feet, he's going to be the new Iman, which is pretty much everything he always wanted. Now, speaking of Amir, you might be asking, didn't they flirt with the idea of him having inhuman powers too? Well, they totally did, and while nothing became of that, it seems that the inhuman gene has been passed down to his kid. But that's going to have to be a story for another day. So that was Ms. Marvel issue number 37, everybody, and I gotta say, this was a real special kind of issue. G. Willow Wilson is winding down her run, and it seems that she's doing a lot of work to connect these new stories to how it all began almost 5 years ago now. And I gotta say, I respect her for telling these subtle, understated, very personal stories to close out her run, where I think a lot of other writers would say, no, I need to blow up the status quo, I need to do something huge before I leave. The real message of this issue is not just how far Kamala has come as Ms. Marvel and as a superhero, but how she's actually gone out of her way to inspire and bring out the heroism in pretty much everyone she's met in Jersey City. So, you know, the ultimate message and takeaway here is a hero really is you. Overall, I'd give this issue an 8.5 out of 10, and I'm very interested for the big special issue that number 35 will be, a celebration of 5 years of the character.
Hey there everyone, it's your old pal Cave Drool again, and I want to thank you so much for watching to the end of the video. I hope you enjoyed it, and if you did, why not check out some of these other videos I have available from the channel. That you can follow me on Twitter and Facebook at Cave Drool, so you're always up to speed on what I'm doing next. And hey, if you really like what I do, you might want to pick up a Cave Drool shirt. Yes, that's right, I have my own merch store over at TeePublic. Check out for great designs like my little cape man, stuff from the comic multiverse, fun stickers, in-jokes, we got it all over at the TeePublic store. You can check it out right now. And I will be sure to see you all again next time. Bye-bye.